Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, we're going to look at how to use CGo. This is the Go package that lets you use C libraries in Go by way of Go's foreign function interface. Now, in a previous video, I demonstrated how to do something like this in Python, where I was showing you how to use C-types or Cython to wrap a simple Windows DLL. And in this video, I'm going to use the same basic example, just adapted for the Go world. So I have here a simple DLL that I've written in C, which exposes a single function named inverse. This time around, however, instead of using MSVC, I'm using the GCC compiler to compile the library on Windows. This is going to bring things more in line with what would happen on other platforms. Now, to create an interface to a C library in Go, we have a package that is called simply C, and we import it like any other package. But in order to make it understand what we're working with on the C side of things, we have to perform a little bit of magic. We need to indicate where our source files are for our C library, and we need to provide references to the headers for the library that we're going to use. So to do this, we import C as the first import in our file, and then immediately above it, we have a special comment block that will describe the C parameters that we need to be working with. So, for instance, in this first line here, we have instructions that we're going to be passing to the C linker. This source dir variable that we have here, this gets substituted at compile time with the directory that our Go source files live in. So we can use that as a starting point to indicate to the linker where our library source files are going to live. And we also have to pass flags to indicate what library we're linking in. In this case, we're linking in DLL1. And then the next line is just a copy of the line that we would use in a C program to indicate the headers that we're talking about. It's just a header import. And again, we need to supply a path to those headers. So this whole preamble, as it's called, by the way, this could actually contain any valid C code. We could write entire functions here if we wanted to, and I will give you a demonstration of that in just a little bit. But to interface with an external library, all we need is an include. One more side note about this preamble block. You cannot have any vertical white space in your code between the preamble and the import C statement. No extra blank lines. This tripped me up more than a few times when I was trying to get this demonstration to run, so be forewarned. So once we've set all this up, the C module will allow us to work with the library in question by exposing the functions that we're describing in its namespace. So here's what I mean by this. This one function that we have in the C library is called inverse, so we can now, after this setup, refer to it by calling c.inverse. The tricky thing, however, is that whatever we pass into it has to be a native C type. It cannot be a Go type. We can't use Go types as is. So the Go bool type, for instance, doesn't automatically map to a C integer. First, we have to convert our Go bool into a Go integer, and then convert that into a C integer to pass into the function. And likewise, the results we get back from the C call don't automatically map to any Go types, so we have to perform conversion processes for that too. This is something you really need to keep in mind when interfacing between C and Go. There is no automatic mapping of types in either direction. So if we run this code, we will get back the inverse of false, which is true, and we're getting this from our C library. Now, here's a slightly more advanced example of embedding C code into a Go application. This I adapted from CGo's own documentation. So in the preamble block for this example, we have what could be an entire standalone C program. It takes string input and prints it to the console. To call this from Go, however, I need to do a few things. First off, I can't pass a Go string to a C function, as you probably figured out by now. I have to convert it to a C string with the C package, and I have to pass that. And I also have to manually free the pointer that was created to pass to that C function. So Go's automatic memory management is inherently at odds with C's manual memory management. And nowhere do these differences become clearer when you try to get the two languages to interface with each other. For instance, one of the other things you can't do yet is pass a function pointer around in this form. It's possible this may be a functionality that is exposed later, but right now we don't have that. So to sum up, you use the C package, or CGo, to interface Go with C code or C libraries. But the two languages don't interface automatically or directly with each other, especially when it comes to passing data types back and forth. You have to convert Go types to C and vice versa, and you have to take extra precaution when handling things like pointers. So that's it for now. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.